to believe. Hope you guys are having a great time in the Bahamas. Welcome everybody to the beautiful cloisters of Atlantis, Paradise Island.
Wow, they made it. Beautiful couple. Almost on time. All right. Well, Daniel and Magdalena, so good to see both of you finally, and we've come to this point. I said as we were talking, I've got to ask these two legal questions just to ensure that we're in the right place, in the right frame of mind. So let me start with you, Daniel. Daniel DaCosta, you come today indicating that you are of sound mind. If you are in agreement, you can answer yes to that question.
Yes.
And that there is no legal reason why you should not be married to Magdalena today. If you are in agreement with that, you can answer no.
No.
Okay. Magdalena, I'm not even going to try to pronounce the last name. You come today indicating that you are of sound mind. If you are in agreement, you can answer yes to that question.
Yes.
And that there is no legal reason why you should not be married to Daniel today. If you're in agreement, you can answer no to that question.
No.
Thank you so very much. You may be seated this afternoon. It's been a long journey for Daniel and Magdalena. 5 or 6 years ago, you met each other, and here you are now ready to commit your vows to each other as husband and wife. And to you, family and friends, welcome today to this celebration with Daniel and with Lena. I want you to know that Daniel and Magdalena have brought us together here today for an occasion of great joy and a cause for great celebration. Having found each other, they have built the kind of relationship that will serve them well as the foundation for their marriage. Daniel and Lena have chosen each one of you to be here with them, to be their witnesses to their wedding vows as they join together today as husband and wife. And so Daniel and Lena, I want to remind you that marriage is a bold step into an unknown future. It is risking who we are for the sake of who we can be in marriage. Two lives are ultimately shared, and the blending of the two must not diminish either one. Rather, it should enhance the individuality of each partner. So Daniel and Lena, each of us knows that marriage is not created by a law or ceremony. Rather, it occurs in the heart of two human beings, as you've come to celebrate today. It grows out of loving, caring, and sharing ourselves with another. Daniel and Lena, this ceremony is not magic. It will not create a relationship that does not already exist and has not already been celebrated in all the commitments that you have made to each other, both large and small. Are you okay? So Daniel and Lena, in the days since you first met and recognized your connection to one another. So in witnessing this ceremony today, we are observing only the outward sign of an inward union that already exists between yourselves. Thus, this ceremony is a symbol of how far you have come together and a symbol of the promise that you will make to each other to continue your lives together and to love each other solely and above all others. I also want to remind you, family and friends, the bride and groom wants to thank each of you for coming today to share in this very special time in their lives. Those of you who have been invited here to witness their wedding, can I also say those who are invited via stream, that's all right? Because they're watching also. All right.
If they can hear us.
And to celebrate with them today will play your part in their marriage too. There are only two official witnesses at a wedding, but each and every person here today will witness the words that Daniel and Lena will speak to one another and the vows that they will make together. I also want to remind you that you should take great care to remember these words. For a marriage needs the help of a community of friends and family who will be there when needed and will do all that they can during hard times to stand by Daniel and Lena and to offer your support to them and the new family that they create today as husband and wife. May you always do all in your power as family and friends to support this union between Daniel and Lena that will be made here today and to nurture the bond between them whom you love. It is through loving, kindness, caring, and sharing that a successful marriage is created. So Daniel and Lena, to you in particular, I want to remind you that a good marriage takes patience, takes dedication, takes humor, takes forgiveness. In this spirit of kindness and humor, I've also been asked to repeat a poem entitled All I Ever Really Needed to Know I Learned in Kindergarten. I think this is the first time I've heard it, but I'm going to read it anyhow. It's by Robert Fulghum. Here it goes. All of what I really need to know about how to live and what to do, and how to be, I learned in kindergarten. Wisdom was not at the top of the graduate school mountain, but there in the sandbox at nursery school. These are the things I learned. Share everything. Play fair. Don't hit people in kindergarten, for real. Put things back where you found them. Clean up your own mess. I guess this is a special poem too. Don't take things that aren't yours. Say sorry when you hurt somebody. Wash your hands before you eat. Flush, that's important. Warm cookies and cold milk are good for you. Give them to someone who feels sad. Live a balanced life. Learn some and think some and draw and paint and sing and dance and play and work every day. Take a nap every afternoon. That's interesting. Be aware of wonder. Remember the little seed in the plastic cup. The roots go down and the plant goes up. And nobody really knows how or why. But we are all like that. Everything you need to know is in there somewhere. And it is still true. No matter how old you are, when you go out into the world, it is best to hold hands and stick together. So Daniel and Lena, a successful marriage is not something that just happens. It takes work. It takes patience and it takes time. It takes a commitment from both of you, a commitment to do whatever it takes to make your relationship thrive and not just simply survive. And so, in this spirit, Daniel, beginning with you, I'm going to ask you, and if you are in agreement, you can answer at the end of it, I do. Do you, Daniel, promise to take Magdalena to be your wife? Do you promise to kill do you promise to kill spiders and everything else that she deems creepy or gross? If you ever find yourself sinking in a paddle boat, do you attest that it is your turn to swim? Do you promise to do the stuff neither of you want to do, even if you don't want to do it more than she doesn't? Think hard. If you're in agreement with that, you can answer, I do.
I do.
He said, I do. Magdalena, to you. Do you, Magdalena, promise to take Daniel to be your husband? Do you promise to let him rein you in at the shoe store? All right. Because you probably have enough shoes for now. Do you promise to try not to steal the covers at night or beat Dan up because you're having that ninja dream again? Do you promise to try not to bring home any more strays? Think hard before you answer, I do. If you're in agreement with that, you can answer, I do.
I do.
She answers, I do. And so, Daniel, Magdalena, the symbolic vows that you are about to take, you are about to make, are a way of saying to one another, you know all those things we've promised and hoped and dreamed well. I meant it all. That's what you're saying, every word. Before this moment, you have been many things to one another. Acquaintance, friend, companion, lover, and even teacher. For you have learned much from one another in these last few years. Now, Daniel and Lena, you shall say a few words, and things will never quite be the same between you. For after these vows, you shall say to the world, this is my husband, and this is my wife. So Daniel, now would you repeat to Lena after me, please? I, Daniel. Promise to love you.
Promise to love you.
Respect you.
Respect you.
Support you.
Support you.
And above all else.
And above all else.
Promise to hold off.
Promise to hold off.
On watching the next episode.
On watching the next episode.
Of whichever show we're into.
Whichever show we're into.
Until we can watch it together.
Until we can watch it together.
Those are some serious words. Now, with Magdalena after me, would you repeat your vows to Daniel today? I, Magdalena. Promise to love you.
Promise to love you.
To respect you.
To respect you.
To support you.
To support you.
And above all else.
And above all else.
I'm sorry. Make sure I'm not just yelling.
Make sure I'm not just yelling.
At you.
At you.
Because I'm hungry.
Because I'm hungry.
These are the vows that Daniel and Magdalena have shared with each other today as they move along this journey to be husband and wife. And as an outward symbol, they've come today to show their love through the giving and the receiving of rings, I'm going to ask now if you would come and bring the rings. Daniel and Magdalena, you've brought rings. I want to remind you of two things quickly. One, your rings are made of circles. So may your love never have an ending. And then your rings are made of precious metal. So in those tough times, I'm sure there won't be many, right? When you remember this commitment that you've made to each other, the metal will remind you of the strength of your marriage, of how you can make it through tough times. Daniel, would you take Lena's ring now? Would you hold it at the tip of her ring finger there, please? And can you share after me? Lena, sorry, let me give you the right name. Magdalena.
Magdalena.
This ring.
This ring.
Symbolizes my love for you.
Symbolizes my love for you.
And the commitments.
And the commitments.
We make together today.
We make together today.
As you wear it.
As you wear it.
Know that I love you always.
Know that I love you always.
Would you slip it on now? Can you get it on? It's all right. Would you take Daniel's ring there? And would you put it at the tip of his finger, and would you share to Daniel after me, please? Daniel.
Daniel.
This ring symbolizes my love for you.
This ring symbolizes my love for you.
And the commitment.
And the commitment.
We make today.
We make today.
As husband and wife.
As husband and wife.
As you wear it.
As you wear it.
Know that I love you always.
Know that I love you always.
Would you slip it on now?
That was easier.
And so, Magdalena and Daniel, in the presence of your family and friends who have joined us here today to share in this moment of joy in your lives, you have declared your deep love and affection for each other. You have stated your wish to live together always open to a deeper, richer friendship and partnership as husband and wife. You have formed your own union based on respect and honor and humor. It's good to laugh. No one but you can declare yourselves married. You have begun this process here today in speaking your vows before your family and friends. And you will do it again, I'm sure, in the days and the years to come, standing by each other, sharing all that is sweet and bitter in life. Each tender act, each loving word will be the declaration of what you have made together here today in your vows as husband and wife. And so before I make the official pronouncement, we'll go through the legal process. And you're going to take your bride now. Would you come and let's share in signing of the register? I'm going to ask now the two witnesses if they would come also. Marina, Magdalena. You've come today, this moment. You've declared your vows to each other and shared your love to each other in a public setting. Would you place your hand in mine, please? Daniel, yours to the bottom. The ring hand, I'm sorry. Lena, yours to the top. And so, it is my privilege and my joyful responsibility to officially acknowledge as a minister, as a marriage officer of the Commonwealth of the Bahamas, I now pronounce you husband and wife. And Lena asked me, what about the kiss? So I'm gonna step aside. Lena, sorry, Daniel, you can now kiss your bride.
Bravo!
All right, you take your flower now in your hands. Mr. Costa, that's what you, okay. Would you take your bride's hands? You can hold her now. Ladies and gentlemen, on this 27th day of October 2016, here in our beautiful Bahamas, I pronounce for the first time Mr. and Mrs. DeCosta. Give them a hand as they walk off into the sunset. Congratulations to you.
And beneath the starlit skies, within the dreams at night, with our hands full of hope, and nothing too dangerous, cause we just cannot lose. With our love on this river we'll flow.
Marvelous night for a moon dance. The stars up above in your eyes. A fantabulous night to make romance. Beneath the cover of October skies. The leaves on the trees, they are falling. To the sound of the breezes that blow. I'm trying to please to the calling of your heartstrings that pray sweet and low. And all the night magic seems to whisper a hush. And all the pale moonlight seems to shine in your blush. Can I have one more moon dance with you, my love? Can I make some more romance, baby, with you, my love? Well, I wanna make love to you tonight. I can't wait till the morning has come. I know that the time is just right now. Straight to my arms you will run. When you come, my arms will be waiting to make sure that you're never alone. There and then all my dreams will come true now. There and then I will make you my own. And every time I touch you, you just tremble inside. And I know how much you need me, that you can't hide. Can I have one more moon dance with you, my love? Can I make some more romance, baby, with you, my love? Time I touch you, you just tremble inside. And I know how much you need me, that you can't hide. Can I have one more moon dance with you, my love? Can I make some more romance, baby, with you, my love?
Okay, so we're gonna do this half what I've written, half kind of from the hip. It's how I roll. So I met Lena in college. We were in the same law class together, and we got assigned to a group project. Now, anyone who knows Lena knows she's kind of a perfectionist. Shocking. If that's a shock to anyone here, I'm sorry. But she is, and we're both the same way, and we hated everyone else in our group. There's no better way to bond than by hating everyone else that's in the group with you. Now, let's talk about the moment that I knew her and Dan would be together forever. I was in her Fall River apartment. We were making flaming chocolate cupcakes. Yeah, I don't think there's enough words to describe how much I hated those cupcakes, but that's fine. Hope you enjoyed them. So she makes the cupcakes, she makes the frosting, she makes everything. We're trying to get the Bacardi 151 to light on fire, and it doesn't work. Like, the one thing that's supposed to be easy doesn't work. And I honestly think it's a great, like, analogy for your entire relationship, and hear me out. You guys book the whole thing, whatever. A hurricane hits, there's nothing you can do, but you've made the best of it. And it's really, like, it just shows how far you guys have come. There's no one that I could pick better to balance Lena out than you, Dan. I couldn't pick anyone better. You balance out everything that, every crazy that she has, you fix. And I think it's great. I can't say enough about it. And I love the adventures that you've had, that you're going to have. The honeymoon that you have planned is just gonna be great. And I really hope that you guys enjoy it. I'm going to keep this short because no one wants to listen to me forever, but I'd like to raise a glass to Lena and Dan. I'll grab one.
Maybe.
Got it. So cheers to you guys. I couldn't pick someone better if I tried to balance Lena, and she really means a lot to me. I cried during her ceremony, and anyone who knows me knows I don't cry. So I wish you two the most happiness in the world. I couldn't be happier.
Cheers!
Your turn.
All right. Well, good job there, Kate. Listen, I want to thank you all for being here, first of all. I know everybody came from a long way, and I know Dan and Lena really appreciate you guys being here and been through a lot, so... I've known Dan since, middle school? I think we were in middle school. Our mothers were both teaching together at the same school, and I can remember from the beginning, we just bonded, and we'd walk back from school and go hang out at South School for a while, and you know, we played baseball together, and we've been through a lot together. He's the kind of guy that, you know, I can always depend on, and I know he depends on me, and just always have get along and never had any problems, and I love you, man. So I know when he and Lena met at the bank, it was just kind of like it was meant to be, you know, and I'm just so happy that both of them have found each other, and all of you families are just, you just all match really well, and we all get along so well. So I'm just so happy that this all worked out, and, you know, weather is weather, but we all made it happen, and you guys made it happen, and to see you guys both smiling, I know it warms all our hearts. So I'll keep it short too. Just happy for you guys. I know you're gonna live a long, happy life together and travel everywhere, and I'm gonna keep talking and grab my beer. Would have been nice if the music was playing behind me, but cheers to both of you guys. Cheers to everybody that made it out here, and let's have some fun tonight.
Every smile for the man who held your hand beneath the pale moonlight. But don't forget who's taking you home and in whose arms you're gonna be. So darling, save the last dance for me. Oh, I know that the music's yes, fine like sparkling wine. Go and have your yes, fun. Laugh and sing.
Yes, I know.
But while we're apart, don't give your yes, heart to anyone. But yes, don't forget who's taking you home and in whose arms you're gonna be. So darling, say the last dance for me. Baby, don't you know I love you so? Can't you feel it when we touch? I will never, never let you go. I love you oh so much. You can dance,
you can dance.
Go and carry on till the night is gone and it's time to go.
You can dance.
If he asks,
you can dance.
If you're all alone, can he take you home? You must tell him no. 'Cause don't